Sonic the Hedgehog, Street Fighter 2, Road Rash 2, and Gremlins. If you don't know and love them, for goodness sake, stay away from Earls Court 2 until next Monday. And don't go near the place unless you're very young and have an awful lot of concentration. It's not all electronic. You can become a lemming with a painted face and green hair, which entitles you to hang around Earls Court as long as you like. But mostly it's computer-based. Movers and shakers in the electronic games game are competing for the lion's share of one of the fastest-growing industries in the country. And with Christmas on the way, they're going all out to win, and the winnings are worth having.
This industry is forecast to be growing to be worth £1 billion come 1993, and then a further up to £1.3 billion for 1994. It's booming massively. It's one of Britain's fewest booming industries.
And that's in the middle of a recession.
Yeah, it's quite crazy, isn't it? There's been a phenomenal boom on Nintendo, Sega, and on Commodore Amiga products. It's taken over a whole generation of kids, and this show is testament to that.
And say that again, even with such high prices, most youngsters seem to be experts.
You get like a bit of a buzz by playing it. You find quite a lot of them interesting. You just can't stop playing them.
Are you very good at these, then?
I'm good at some other ones, but I'm not so good at this one.
Most of the games here are quite dated.
Something to do, challenging tasks.
Things to wash up, that's fairly challenging.
People like to play them for fun and enjoy it. They get enjoyment out of them.
When you're only 4 and a half, reaching the controls is more of a challenge than winning the game, and far more interesting than talking to TV crews.
Oh, golly, and you're very good at this, aren't you, this game? Do you think you could teach me? No, why is that? Am I too old?
It's a wise woman who knows when to give up and go home. Good night.
That was Pleasure Ignorance for Thames News. Thank you.